Hi, my name is Dr. Mark B. Hubble, and this is your Monday morning mini message. First off, I just want to thank everybody who commented or liked or shared the message that I gave on Saturday about my wife being pregnant, and we are excited about having this baby. And it was definitely prayer answered, and I'm so thankful that God answers our prayers, even the ones that may seem unlikely to be answered, or even near impossible to be answered. Now, I know that there's times when I pray for things, and I'm guilty of it myself, where I'm praying, but I really am not praying like I mean it. I'm praying like I would like for it to happen, but I'm not praying like I really have the faith backing that prayer that I know God will come through and make it happen. In the book of Mark, chapter 5, verses 28 to 34, it's a story about a woman who's basically been having her period for 12 years, okay? Which any woman out there, I'm sure, would be like, yeah, I would want that to stop as well. So she was very disheartened because she had seen numerous doctors and physicians. They all tried to help her and nothing would help her. But then she found out that Jesus was coming through town. And she thought in her mind, her faith was so strong, she said, if I could just get close enough to him to touch the hem of his robe, I'll be healed of this issue of blood. So the crowd is moving and she finds her way close and she grabs that hem of Jesus's robe and boom, she is instantly healed. Now her faith is so strong that Jesus, in this huge crowd of people, turns around and says in Mark chapter 5 verse 30, I just felt power go out of me. Who touched me? And his disciples are kind of laughing like, Jesus, there's 100 people around you. How do we know who touched you? And Jesus is still looking around. And the woman, overcome with humility and joy at the same time, she says, I'm the one who touched you, Jesus. And he said, woman, your faith has healed you. So she was in a position that when she touched his robe, power actually came out of Jesus. So her faith was so strong, it actually drew power out of God. And I think that when we pray, we need to come to God with that kind of power. We need to come to God with that kind of fervent faith that we say, whatever I speak, if it is in God's will come into existence. And there's so many things in my life. There's a laundry list of things I could list that I was praying half-heartedly and God answered wholeheartedly. So now I pray wholeheartedly, and if God answers only half-heartedly, I still have more than what I thought I would have before. And it's not about always what we want and getting things. It's about having a faith that says, no matter what, I'm going to serve God, and I'm going to do whatever it takes to do His will in my life and to share His love with others whenever I have a chance. So think about this as you go about your week. In your prayer life, are you praying like you mean it? Because if you're not, I suggest you put your full backing of faith behind every prayer that you say and believe that God will deliver. Thank you for sharing this time with me. Take care and God bless.